Hi friends, as we have seen in our previous session, algebra is used quite frequently in our day-to-day lives. Maybe sometimes we won't realize it. Let's discuss some situations and learn some interesting concepts in algebra. Suppose a school decides to go on a picnic. Teacher has given two choices to students, a water park and a football match. Some students chose water park and some decided for football match. Students going to visit water park needs to pay amount 120 as fee, whereas the students who will be going for football match will have to pay 150 bucks as fee. Now, teacher wanted to know the total amount collected for all the students going for water park. For one student, fees is 120 bucks. So for two students, amount will be 120 into 2, that is 240 bucks. For 3, it will be 120 into 3, that is 360. But as of now, he doesn't know the number of students going for water park. Therefore, he took the number of students as x, which is any unknown number. So the amount will be 120 into x, right? Similarly, if y numbers of students are going for football match, then the total fees for it will be 150 into y. Therefore, the total amount for both the places can be calculated as 120 into x plus 150 into y. If we close the analyze here, 120 and 150 are the fees, which is a fixed amount. Whereas x and y are the number of students, which may vary. So suppose there are 40 students in total, then we can write x plus y equals to 40. Does this look familiar? Yes. In our previous session, we have studied about algebraic expression, equations, constants and variables. So if 30 students are going for water park and 10 are going for football match, then total amount will be 120 into 30 plus 150 into 10, that is 5100 bucks. Friends, here 120 and 150 are called constants. X and Y are called variables, and when they combined with the fundamental operations forms algebraic expression. Let's proceed further to learn few more things about algebraic expressions. Here the formula to obtain the fees for students going for water park, that is 120 into x, is called as a term. Similarly, 150 into y is also a term. Now suppose after visiting the water park, same number of students x are again going to visit the museum with 200 as an entry fee, then what will be the total amount? It will be 200 into x, right? And here 200 into x is again a term. Now suppose school has already paid 500 bucks for snacks for the students visiting the museum. Then the total expenditure will be 200x plus 500. So here, can we call 500 also as a term? Yes, it is a term. In fact, here variables x and y are also called terms. So let's define a term now. A term is either a single number or a variable, or numbers and variables multiplied together in an expression. So finally, the amount spent on the whole trip, that is water park, football match and the museum, is 120x plus 150y plus 200x plus 500. Here we can see that the terms are added together to form an expression. Friends, we now know that a term is basically multiplication of numbers and variables. And these numbers and variables are individually called as factors. So here fees 120 and number of students x are the two factors of the term 120x. Similarly, 150 and y are called as the factors of the term 150 into y. Please note that there can be many factors to a number. For example, 2 multiplied by 60 multiplied by x is again equals to 120 into x. So here the numbers 2, 60 and x are also factors of 120x. Now we can also see that the factors are either numbers or variables. Friends, the numerical factors are called as the coefficients, and we read it as 120 is a coefficient of x, 150 is a coefficient of y. I hope you have understood everything so far. Friends, if you remember, the same number of students who went to the water park visited the museum too. And so we took the same variable x to form both the terms. And such terms are called as like terms. Therefore, here 120x and 200x are called like terms. Mathematically, like terms are those terms that have same variables and their powers. On the other hand, terms which do not have same variables with their powers are called unlike terms. Here 120x and 150y. 150y and 200x are called unlike terms. So, as I have said something about power in the definition of like terms, can you tell what is power? Power of a number says that how many times a variable or a number is multiplied. Just say, for example, 25 is obtained by multiplying 5 twice. So here 2 is the power of 5. So friends, in an expression, the highest power of a variable defines the degree of that expression. As we can see here, the highest power is 1. Therefore, the degree is 1. Now look at this expression. Can you tell the degree of this? It is 3 because the highest power of x is 3. Now if I remove x cube, then can you tell the degree of this? Are you going to say that the degree is 2? So let me tell you, if you are thinking that the degree is 2, then you are wrong. Here the degree is still 3. Because when we have two variables in a term, we should add the powers of both. Now the last thing that we are going to understand is the classification of expressions. Friends, algebraic expressions are classified based on its number of terms. As we just studied, an expression can be of a single term, it can have two terms, three terms, or simply it can be more than three terms. When we have one term, the expression is called monomial. When we have two terms, we call it as binomial. Expressions having three terms are called trinomials. And expressions more than three terms are simply called polynomials. So that's all for this session. Let's check how much we have understood by attempting the following questions. So having understood algebraic expression well and different notions involved, now I'm curious to know what if we can add two algebraic expressions together, or if we can subtract and multiply them just like we do with numbers, because in algebraic expression, along with the numbers, variables are also used. So how to do basic operations with expressions? We are going to learn these things in our upcoming sessions. So friends, I am sure you have found this session easy, useful and understood the various concepts that we have discussed today. But still, in case you have any query, do not hesitate to ask us by posting your valuable comments in the below comment box. Till we meet in our next session, keep watching, keep learning.